accounting rate of return, net present value method, profitability index, and internal rate of return. For all this, we have to use cash inflow, cash outflow for evaluation. Under all these methods, the inputs are for evaluation, cash inflow and cash outflow. Cash outflow means cost of investment. Cash inflow means the revenue. For only one method, we will use EAT or PAT, earnings after tax or profit after tax. For ARR, accounting rate of return, if you are evaluating the proposal by using ARR, so then one input is earnings after tax or profit after tax. Another one is cost of project. In other cases, in the rest of the four methods, cash inflow or cash flow, or we may call it as cash flow after taxes, CFAT. For all the rest four methods, we use CFAT. Only for one method, EAT or PAT is used. So today we are going to see the payback period method. Payback period itself says how much we invested, how much time it will take for payback, pay return. So that is payback period method. How much time it will take for returning our investment. So which proposal repay us earlier, that will be accepted. So it's in a layman method. Just simply we are comparing with our investment and return. So how much time it will take for repaying our returns, which repay us earlier, we will accept that one. The remaining are rejected. So it's a very simple and easiest method of evaluation. Okay, hope you are able to see the screen. Is it? Yes, are you able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
So up to this, we had seen in the previous class methods of evaluation. Payback period method. So the payback period helps to determine the length of time required to recover the initial cash outlay. So the time required to recover the initial cash outlay in the project. Simply, it is the method used to calculate the time required to earn back the cost incurred in the investments through the successive cash inflows. So just we'll see the time it takes to repay our investment. of our calculation, again here, the cash inflows are classified into two types. One is even cash inflow, where another one is uneven cash inflow. Means the returns, if it is fixed throughout the life, every year you are getting the same amount as a it is not same. Okay, as admission is going on, they require some inputs. Okay, we'll continue. So when cash inflows are even, so here the two situation, one, is it clear? Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Will I continue?
Continue, sir.
Okay, thank you. So when cash inflows are even, then how to calculate? When cash inflows are not even, how to calculate, we'll see one by one. So even means throughout the life of the asset, we are going to get the same amount. For example, the cost of asset is some cent, and the life of asset is 5 years. And for all the 5 years, we are going to get 5 lakhs. So first year 5 lakhs, second year 5 lakhs, third year 5 lakhs, fourth year 5 lakhs. So it's an even cash inflow. Uneven means first year 5 lakhs, second year 6 lakhs, third year 6 lakhs 50,000, fourth year 6 lakhs 75,000. Like that, it is vary from year to year. So then uneven cash inflow. So when cash inflows are even, then how to calculate? So then cash inflows are even, payback period is equal to initial outlay divided by annual cash inflow. See, very simple. Initial cash outlay plus divided by annual cash inflow. Then here initial cash inflow means, initial cash outlay means cost of project plus transportation, installation, all those things. Then here the selection criteria, accept or reject. So if, so with the project which is repaying earlier, that should be accepted. A, B, C is there. A, 2 years. B, 1.5 years. Three years. So B is 1.5 year. So among the three, B is repaying earlier. So we are accepting B. We will reject the remaining proposals. And one more, if the management fixed some standard payback period, so it should be returned on or before so and so year. So then we will compare with the standard payback period. If it is on par with or less than that standard payback period, then that will be accepted. Otherwise, it will be rejected. So that is a selection criterion. Okay, it's clear. Just simply verify cost of asset divided by annual cash inflow. So now, an example, a company in finalization of investment proposal, cost of project is 10,20,000, transportation 80,000, and installation charges 1,50,000. Estimated life of the project is 5 years, and standard payback period 2.5 years. So it should be less than 2.5, then only you have to accept. Expected cash inflow per annum, 3 lakhs. So every year you are getting 3 lakhs as a return cash inflow. So suggest the management in implementation of the project. So the cash inflows are E1. So we have to calculate payback period by cost of asset divided by annual cash inflow. So the cost of asset is equal to cost of project plus transportation and installation. So in this question, the cost of project is 10,20,000, transportation is 80,000, and installation charges 1,50,000, put together 12,50,000. Then the payback period is equal to 12,50,000 divided by annual cash inflow, that is 3,4.17 years. So the payback period is 4.17, where the standard payback period is 2.5 years. So reject the proposal, as the project period is less greater than the standard payback period, hence the project is rejected. See how simple it is. This is 5 marks question. Okay, the next one, when cash inflows are not even, so this is cash inflow is even. Now we will see when cash inflows are not even. So then we have to construct a cumulative cash inflow. So the first year and add first year to second year, then add second year to third year, then third year you have to add like that. You have to add the successive year cash inflows. Or where it is equivalent to cost of project, then that will be payback period. So that corresponding year will be payback period. So here you will add the cash inflows year on year, where in which year it will become equal to our cost of project, the year will be treated as a payback period. So first we have to construct a cumulative cash inflow. In cumulative cash inflow, where it is equivalent to initial outlay of cash, so the corresponding year is payback period. Then accept and reject criteria will be the same. Which will repair earlier, that will be accepted. If we are having standard payback period, then we will compare with the standard payback period. If it is less than the standard payback period, then only we will accept. Otherwise, we will reject. Okay. Now it will be clear by seeing this example. A company in finalization of investment proposal, cost of project 10,20,000, transportation 80,000, installation charges 1,50,000, as the same in the previous question. Estimated life of the project is 5 years and standard payback period is 2.5 years. Expected cash inflow in earlier annual cash inflow 3 lakhs. In this expected cash inflow per annum, first year is 3,50,000, second year 4,50,000, third year 4,50,000, fourth year 4 lakhs, fifth year 3 lakhs. So you have to help the management in implementation of project. So now the cost of project, as we had seen earlier, the same 10,20 plus 80 plus 150. So the total is 12,50,000. Then we have to construct a cumulative cash inflow. So in cumulative cash inflow, years we had taken 5 years, then the first year 350, second year 450, third year 450, fourth year 4 lakhs, fifth year 3 lakhs. Then you have, this is the given in the question. Now you will construct a cumulative cash inflow. So first year 3,50,000, 3,50,000 plus 4,50,000, 8 lakhs. 8 lakhs plus 4,50,000, 12,50,000. 12,50,000 plus 4 lakh, 6,50,000. 6,50,000 plus 3 lakhs, 19,50,000. So in this way, we have to construct a cumulative cash inflow. Now we have to see where it is equivalent to cost of project. So the cost of project is 12,50,000. So at 12,50,000, we are getting at the end of the third year. So the payback period is 3 years. So the payback period is 3 years. As the standard payback period is 2.5 years, so we are getting at the end of the third year. So reject the proposal. Reject the proposal. Okay, is it clear? Any doubt? Hello. Have you found? Any doubt? No doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Then this is the question we had seen in the 2016 or 17 for 10 marks. This is a 10 marks question. See how simple it is. Now you are realizing. If you know these things, you are able to score full marks. Why I am saying, go through all this. So it's just a sample we are seeing. Okay, this unit is, I already said, very simple and easiest unit among all the remaining unit. Okay, a company finalizing a capital outlay of a project help the management in decision making using the payback period method. So the cost of project of project A and project B is 1 lakh. For both, it's 1 lakh. The life is 4 years. So the first year 40, second year 30, fourth year 30, third year 30, fourth year 10,000. Project B, first year 10, 20, 30, 40. So the cost of project is 1 lakh. Estimated cash inflows are 4 years given. So we have to calculate payback period. For that, we have to construct a cumulative cash inflow. Calculation of payback period. So first, you will take the values given in the question. First, second, third, fourth year. So 40,000, 30,000, 20,000, and 10,000. Cumulative cash inflow, 40. 40 plus 30, 70. 70 plus 20, 90. 90 plus 10, 1 lakh. So it is becoming 1 lakh at the end of fourth year. So payback period is fourth year for project A. Now project B, 10,000, 20,000, 30,000, 40,000. Cumulative cash inflow, first year 10,000, 10 plus 20, 30,000, 30 plus 30, 60,000, 60 plus 40, 1 lakh. This one also becoming 1 lakh at the end of the fourth year. So the payback period of the project B also fourth year. So now, which one you are going to recommend? Both the payback period for both the project is 1 lakh. Which one you are going to recommend?
Project B, sir.
Project B. Why project B? See, both are same means some reason should be there why you are suggesting project B. Yes,
sir. Project A, sir.
Project A. Why project A?
Sir, cumulative cash inflow is more, sir, the first, second, third year compared to project B.
Oh, very good, very good. In project, someone has said project A has, it's an incremental, year on year it is increasing. That's why they had suggested project B. Yes? Anything? So finally, project A or project B?
A, sir.
A. Not B. See, in case of performance, if you are taken, see, in case of monetary things, it is different. So if you are thinking in the perspective of the performance, so project B is good. Performance, first year it is less, and second year it is increased, third year it is further increased, fourth year it is more. So performance is based. If we are studying, then the project B is good, where the in case of performance, so the first year is good, second, third, fourth year, fifth year, it is decreasing. Same way, if I borrowed money from you, for example, the same 1 lakh I borrowed from you, I had given two options. One is I will pay in 4 quarters, so that installments either first 40, 30, 20, 10 or 10, 20, 30, 40. Which one you will prefer?
A.
Yeah. Why? Because you are able to recover the maximum amount in the beginning itself. You had given 1 lakh. So at the end of the first quarter, you are going to get 20, 40. And at the end of the second quarter, you are going to receive 70%, 40 plus 30. So if we come to the financial matters, so if you are receiving more in the beginning, so that much risk is reduced. 1 lakh you are given, 40% is recovered, only 60% is left. At the end of the second quarter, 30% is further, means 70% you recovered, only 30% is left. Where in case of project B, 10,000 you received, 90% is left over. The risk is more. After second quarter, the 70% is left over. So the risk is more. So you have to give the same answer. See, this is 10 marks question. Why it is 10 marks means because of this logic only. So your answer, see, the payback period is fourth year. So as the payback period of both the project is fourth year, the project A is repaying more comparing to the project B in the earlier year. Hence, project A is to be accepted. Okay, it is clear. Why we are accepting project A? It is repaying the maximum, or it is repaying more comparing to project B in the earlier year. So we are suggesting project A, or we are accepting project A. Yes, any doubt?
No, sir.
So are you okay with this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So this is when cash inflows are not given. No one is getting any doubt in this.
What happens when cash inflows are even?
Cash inflows are
even.
Even already we had seen. That is very simple.
Yes, sir.
You will get that answer. See, if it is 1 lakh and cash inflows are 25,000 or 40,000, you take 40,000 per annum. So 1 lakh divided by 40, 2.5 is the payback period. Isn't it? 1 lakh divided by 40. So that is even. When it is not even, then you have to do in this way. Anything else? No?
If it decreases, sir.
Which?
Cash inflow.
Cash inflow, if decreases, you will reject, you will not accept. Less than that, then you will not accept. Inka, anything? Nothing? Sir. Yes? Okay, I will give some clue here. So if here, instead of 20, if it is 40, here instead of 30, if it is 50, then the cumulative cash inflow will become how much here? 40 means 110, isn't it? Here 50 means, here also it is 110. Now you tell what is the, which is the payback period?
Three.
In third year, it is more than your amount is 1 lakh, where you are getting 1 lakh 10,000. In both the case, you are getting 1 lakh 10,000, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Then how? Anyone? Yes? All of you listening, na?
Yes, sir.
Am
Yes,
getting
sir.
only one voice in return. Yes? Is it clear?
Yes, sir, it's clear.
Ninety-seven, Kumar. Are you okay, Kumar? 97, Kumar.
Yes, sir.
Is simply saying yes, sir. What is the payback period? We changed the values, so it is more than our investment. Kartik. 75.
Sir.
What is the payback period? Srija. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Not yes, sir. What is the payback period? You are saying simply yes, sir. See what I said here. If we change the value instead of 20, if I make it as a 5, then this the cumulative payback period, cumulative value will become 1 lakh 10,000. Yes, isn't it?
Sir, he can pay in 3 years only, no, sir. Rest of the amount can be as profit.
No. In third year, it is not 70,000 only. Third year, it is more now. Yes, what you said, that is correct. In third year, it is more now. See, if you make it as a 40,000, so the management asks you, what is the payback period? So 1 lakh 10,000. So when you are getting back that one, how much time? If here it is 50, 50 means here it is 110.
80,
Okay.
sir.
Huh? 80, yes, 80. Okay, 80. 80, 40, here 120. Yes. Here it is 80. Here it is 80, and here it will become 120. So, in this case, the payback period falls between these 2 years, second year and third year. In second year, you are able to recover 30,000, 70,000. The remaining 30,000 you have to recover in the succeeding year, where you are getting 40,000. So the part of the third year is repaying your remaining. So for entire year, you are able to recover 40,000. Our requirement is only 30,000. So 3/4 of the year means 2.75 years. 2.75 years. In this case, here the fourth, third year, and plus next year. So in third year, you are able to recover 80,000. How much you have to recover further? You have to recover further 20,000. So how much is available in the next year? 40,000. So for entire year, if it is 40,000, for requiring 20,000 means half. So 0.5. So the payback period will become 3.5. Got the point? Yes.
Yes, sir.
When The cumulative cash inflow, it is not equivalent to cost of project. If it is more, then what we will do? We take the where it is nearer that year. To that, you will add the part of the succeeding year. How you will find that part of the succeeding year? So how much we recovered here? So the cost of asset is 1 lakh minus how much we recovered, 90,000. Then the remaining amount you will get. That remaining amount divided by the amount available in the succeeding year. So then you will get the payback period. So this is one more scenario. When the cumulative cash inflow is not equal to the cost of project, in 1 year it is nearer, in another year it is more, then we have to find out the payback period as falls between those 2 years, within those 2 years. So when cash inflows are not even and cumulative cash inflows is not equal to the initial outlay of the cash, then it falls between 2 years. Where it is necessary to cash outlay that year plus proportionate period of succeeding period. So in recovering the remaining cash outlay. So accept and reject criteria is same. Okay. That will be further cleared by seeing this example. Now, a project, a company finalizing a capital outlay of a project, help the management in decision making using the payback period method. So the cost of project is same, 1 lakh. And cash inflows for first project A, 40, 50, 40, 30. Project B, 30, 50, 50, and 40. So first we have to prepare a cumulative cash inflow. So calculation of payback period, then cumulative cash inflow. We will construct a cumulative cash inflow. So project A, project B. So we'll take the project A. 40, 50, 40, 30. 40, 50, 40, 30. So the year first, second, third, fourth year. In second, project B, 30, 50, 50, and 40. Then cumulative cash inflow, 40 first year, 40 plus 50, 90, 90 plus 40, 130, 130 plus 30, 160. Here, first year 30, 30 plus 50, 80, 80 plus 50, 130, 130 plus 40, 170. So we prepared cumulative cash inflow. In project A, second year is less, in third year it is more. So it falls between second and third year. In case of project B also, it is 80,000. And here it is 130. So here also it falls between second and third year. So the previous year is second year and part of the third year and part of the third year. So cost of project is 1 lakh. We are able to recover 90,000 at the end of the second year. So 1 lakh minus 90,000, further you have to recover 10,000. So what is the succeeding period? Succeeding period, third year, you are getting 40,000. For entire year, it is 40,000. Then for 10,000 is how much? For 10,000 is quarter year, 0.25. So the payback period is 2.25. 2.25. Where in case of project B, here we are able to recover 80,000. Here also the previous year is 2 years, second year plus part of the third year. So second year 80,000 we recovered, cost of project 1 lakh, 1 lakh minus 80,000, you have to recover 20,000 in succeeding year. How much you are getting? 50,000. So 50,000, so 20 divided by 50 means 4.4, so 2.4. Okay, is it clear? You'll see in detail here. So the payback period falls between the 2 years, second year and third year. Then calculation of payback period, previous year. See, the previous year means second year is the previous year. cost of the project 1 lakh, amount recovered up to previous year 90,000, amount available in the succeeding year 40,000, amount available in the succeeding year 40,000. So second year plus 1 lakh minus 90 divided by 40 is 2.25 is the payback period. Is the payback period. In case of next one, so here also it is not 3, 2. Second year is the previous year, and we able to recover 80. So 1 lakh minus 80 means 20,000, and succeeding year amount available 50. So by 50, so 2.4 is the payback period. Okay, now it is clear. Any doubt? So this is 5 marks question. How simple it is. So in payback period, two situation: when cash inflows are even, when cash inflows are not even. When it is even, cost of project divided by annual cash inflow. When not even, you have to construct a cumulative cash inflow, and in that cumulative cash inflow, where it is equivalent, the corresponding year is treated as a payback period. If it is not equivalent, so we have to use this previous year plus proportionate period of the succeeding period. So the previous year plus cost of the project minus amount recovered up to previous year divided by amount available in the succeeding period. Okay, it is clear? Any doubt?
No, sir.
So project A and project B, the project B is to be accepted and project B is to be rejected. So which is repaying earlier? Project A. So you have to accept project A. Then merits. So it's very simple to calculate and easy to understand. Hope you people understand how to solve. This method is helpful in analyzing the risk, that is to determine how long investment will be at risk. So till the amount recovered, it is in risk. So after recovery, total recovery, there is no risk. All those things are treated as profit. So it is beneficial for the industries where the investment becomes absolute very quickly. So very quickly, where the cost of project will become absolute zero, where it is more useful. It measures the liquidity of the project. Liquidity means cash, liquid money. Money is liquid. You are able to convert that one into any form of asset, that is liquid. Any form of asset is converted into cash, that is also nearer to liquid. So the measure liquidity of the project. So all these are merits. Demerits: the major drawback of this project is that ignore the time value of money. So we invested today and you are receiving the money after first year, second year, third year, as it is you are comparing. The things are not same. See, the first year student, second year student, third year student, fourth year student's marks are compared is same way, then it is not correct. Now it is you have to give some grade and you have to compare them. Here also the money what you have received in the first year, second year, third year is not same. The purchasing capacity of money will vary. So you should we ignore the time value of money. It does not taken into the consideration the cash inflows that occurs after the payback period. Only we are focusing up to the payback period. Even though the project which is not repaying earlier, but after that payback period may paying more than the project which one we are selected. So we ignore to consider the amount what we are receiving after the payback period. It does not show the liquidity position of the company. So we are not seeing the liquidity position of the company because of this what would be the effect on the overall liquidity? We are not considering that, but only we tells about the ability of that particular project. So it is centralized. Only we are concentrating on that particular additional project, what we are doing. It does not measure the profitability of, so the to overall entity's profit, how this in adding this affect our profit, is there an increase or decrease, we are not considering, or what is the profitability of that particular project is also not considered. So we are not focusing on that, the time required to recover the initial investment, only our focus. This method does not consider the lifespan of the, so the total life of the asset is not considered. Only we are seeing till the recovery of that asset's life, not the total overall lifespan of that asset. Thus, conclusion, the payback period is very simple. Simplest method to assess the risk associated with the investment and the time required to get the initial outlay. So this is about payback period. So we completed payback period. Yes, are you okay? Any doubt you are having? Yes. Hello.
Yes, sir.
And regarding material and other things, yesterday I told, na FAA Srirangarajan blogspot.com, had I explained about that? Had I shared that information?
Yes sir.
Previous class,
FAA Srirangarajan blogspot.com. Once again, see, for the material and previous year question paper and all these what PPTs, for that I am maintaining a blog. That blog is FAA Srirangarajan blogspot.com. So in that blogspot blog, you are able to see all material relevant to this subject. And PPTs, previous year question papers, objective questions.
Sir, notes.
Notes also. I am showing that one also. See.
Yes, sir.
See the fourth unit. Capital budgeting 1 and 2. See this unit 4. So in this, you are able to see the detailed notes. So this is PPT, sorry. See, problems on capital budgeting 1, 2, 3. Payback period, ARR, net NPV, and PI again into some problems on that. So this one only we had seen, no? Capital budgeting. This is the PPT and material is also available. I show you. Yes, unit 4. So this is the material notes. It's taking time for loading. So in this we are able to see all the details of in detailed explanation of the topics. So both are available. Material is there, notes is there, and PPTs are there. And previous question papers and their solutions, internal papers and internal paper solutions, and some solved problems, see here. So this is ARR, payback period. So traditional method, payback period, accept the criteria, the problem, cumulative cash inflow. Okay, so detailed notes is also available. Just you go through. So I will share the address. It is very simple. Just you Google FAA Srirangarajan, you will get it. Yes. Okay. Yes, anything else? I will take the attendance. Sixty-one absent. Yes, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. You are
audible. Yes, sir.
Okay, 61, 63.